Hello and welcome back to Stranded Deep. Last time we were uncovering the mystery of the exploding raft, and we were going for a little swimmy swim on the bottom of our little lagoon outside of our house, this house here. It's a lovely house on this island with the cook pines and the palm trees and the shipwreck and quietness, stillness, lack of shark-faced sharks. So what I thought we could do this episode is probably get our stuff together and load up the raft again, the big old raft, Yeoman Rand, and then probably sail back to the other side of the map. So this is the line of islands. There's an island there, and if we look in that direction, is that the other island? I think that's the other island, and then beyond that island in the distance there is the sea fort, which we have been to, and then there's a little island there. There's the starting island, there's a big island, and I think way, way off in the distance that we cannot see beyond those seagulls is, I think, the last island in sort of the central island chain that we have actually been to. So we have been to it. Oh, there's a stingray, just kind of being a stingray. Last thing we did last time was we worked out the mystery of the moving bed, which is because seagulls keep flying through the house, because apparently seagulls and sharks and animals in general don't seem to respect like buildings. So they don't see the building as I thought we could scare the seagull through the actual building itself. So it looks like animals interact with physics objects, but they don't interact with the walls of the houses and stuff. So they swim through walls and they swim through stuff. So that kind of means that our little anti-shark swimming under the island thing, which we built here with these ladders going down to stop sharks sort of swimming through here, and then at this point swimming under the island and being a pain in the butt, might not actually do anything, you know? The chest that we lost last time is still down under this sort of weedy stuff. I don't know what's... I don't know any way of actually getting that out from there. I could probably do something in the save game file, the JSON file, which is kind of cool that it's been left open. So that you can actually do stuff like that. Where's our fishing spear gone? I don't know. I do like that. I do like when a game is like fairly open and it allows us to do things like that. We've got some small meat, so we could probably get some more meat from the sea. It's always a bit of a problem going underwater, because first of all, you've got to get underwater. Then you've got to listen for shark noise. And then you've got to get out of the water before you drown and potentially get nommed down like an old Twix by a shark. That's a problem. So we'll drop this down. And what we'll do is we'll put some small meat in the smoker. So I think hold it down and you get the fish, and then you drop the fish, and then you get the knife. And then we can press E to pick up. Hold E to skin. So we need to skin the pilchard in order to get... So we don't get any like... leather from the pilchard. What we do is we do drop our knife on the floor, because that's what we do. And again, oh, whatever, it can stay there. And we get small meat, we drop that down, and then we can physics object with a right mouse button into the smoker. There we go, there's another bit of meat. So pick that up because we need it. Then we pick that up, and then we go another swimmy swim, I guess, maybe. At this point, what could happen is sharks could all spawn in all at once. You'd be like, ah, time is done, ding! Because I think the sharks do spawn back. By reading the JSON file, by reading the save game file, it looks like sharks have like a respawn timer on them. Yeah, so at least some of them do. There's a stingray. Huh. When the game is not trying to kill you, it's actually quite nice. Missed. We're going to drown. What is that? What was that? It looked like a hammer, but I think it's actually... Hang on a minute, let's go back down. Oh, it's just the leg of our building. Ooh, Mr. Stingray. We're not going to do anything with the stingray, because we don't want to anger what could potentially mess us up fun time. Man, there's the box. I don't see any more fish. No more fish. What's this way? Ugh. It's kind of more open... Well, we can have a little looky look. I don't see anything. I don't see any more boxes either. That's the other thing. No more boxes. No more fish. Ooh, no, we're drowning. Ugh. Yeah, Okay, I think that's as much fish as we're going to get for the time being. What happened to our raft? Oh, there it is. So this is the one that freaked out and threw all our boxes. It kind of exploded and threw all our boxes all over the place, which was a pain in the butt. Oh, we got a spare tire. Kind of cool. We have another fishing spear. I think we can actually throw these as well. If we throw it at a tree. Yeah, we can actually throw it. So maybe we can throw fishing spears at sharks. I thought that was a shark noise, but no, it's a motorbike going past the house. Fair enough. Lantern. Okay, so yeah, when we've got all our medicine, we got more morphine than we know what to do with. That's so much morphine. Torches, bandages, beans, duct tape, boat parts. So we've got enough parts to make another engine. I don't know if we put like a. Oh, fire torches, which are useless. Empty. No, I thought it was an empty fire torch. Maybe it's a refined hammer. Okay, fine. Let us put some fuel in the campfire. Let us use some driftwood because this stuff's just kind of hanging around. Oh, there we go. A little bit of driftwood there. So we'll get the driftwood and we'll put it in the old fire here. So we go boop, boop. There we go. I think this was the broken hammer. This hammer doesn't do anything anymore. Because they redid the building mechanics and they were like, oh yeah, but your old hammer's not gonna do anything. So. Oh, okay. Well, I was gonna throw that into the sea, but apparently not. Let's do this. Let's go dun 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 dun. Maybe the sharks can build something. Goodbye. Safe travels. I hope you don't hit a shark in the face, because that would be very funny, actually. Good. And we've got all these boxes full of stuff. Now, to be honest, I don't know if we need to carry more boxes than. I mean, we've got the flare guns. I don't think the flare guns actually do anything. It does say could save your life from skyway predators, but I don't think they actually do that much. We've got palm fronds, one of three. We've got some kindling. We could probably just leave that in there. Empty medicines. Do we need medicines? Or could we like just leave it and think, oh, I'm venturesful. Could it just be like, you know what? We've got so many medicines and stuff we don't actually need to carry. To carry a load of stuff from one island to another. We can always just come back to home island if we get injured. You know, that's always an option. This is like, ah, oh, we're bleeding. Well, just come back to home island and boop. Yeah, we've got so much stuff. So much stuff at this point. What we could do is we could do like a big building project, like expand the house maybe. Oh, I don't know, the house is kind of nice as it is, but we could build a little storage area for like junk, for like this kind of junk, like a little storage shack maybe. I don't know. I don't know. We could probably do that when we get back. Let's prepare. So we don't need the props. Medicines. How much in terms of stuff have we got? Well, we got another full inventory. God damn this inventory system. We probably just leave another crate here, in fact. Is that empty? That crate is actually empty. Huh. So what we could do is just put all our medicines in the crate. Can we get. Ooh. That's not what I wanted to do. So let's pick up all the medicines so they're not kind of laying on the floor. And bandages. Oh, we can't pick them up. God damn. So we'll. Oh, of course. We're holding it. We don't want to be holding it. Because if we want to put it in, holding it counts as one slot. So we'll do this. So this can be our medicine cabinet. There we go. Loads of medicines. Fine. Good. Absolutely brilliant. The food and health and water sitch. Well, it's kind of late in the day. We've got to be able, we're kind of way down on water. That's a bit of an issue for us. Ah, oh, more medicines. The lashings are going to be useful on our journey. This stuff is not. Oh, seriously. But we can leave it here. I don't know about this corrugated scrap because we got loads of it. I mean, we could build like a shack or something. But I don't know what happens. But I don't know whether the corrugated scrap is still in it in the next patch. That's the problem. Plank scrap, I think, is. But the corrugated scrap. Who knows? We also need some place for it to go because this is just stupid. Here looks kind of cool. So if we just drop plank scraps down, these tarps can go here as well. I think So we just get rid of this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Is it stacked that much? Probably. So let's drop this over here as well, so it's not kind of directly in the way. We're always a bit wary about dropping physics objects on other physics objects, because they kind of bounce around. But also, when you come back to the island, what was that? Yep, that's a problem. When you come back to the island, they kind of settle and reset and then bounce around again, because physics objects impart energy into other physics objects, and that kind of causes stuff to... Were there always two shrubs here? Were there always two shrubs here? What? It's kind of weird. I don't know. I mean, the only plants that regrow are these young palm trees. Ooh, palm frond. And no, that's it. I think the young pines don't regrow, and the fruit trees do, and you get quava, but only if you farm them. So if you pick the fruit from the trees in the wild, they don't regrow fruit. I don't think the coconuts regrow. We could run a little experiment. Yeah. All right. So this of these two trees, these two really tall trees next to this corrugated metal planter, one has no coconut, the other one has a coconut. And just make sure this one's completely empty. So we'll now know if this regens a coconut, we'll know. Okay, cool. That's a cool thing we can do. Water. We need water. We need to drink water. We need to... Nom, 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 nom. Ah, refreshing. Kind of like, kind of like water, I guess. Water that's not full of salt and fish poop. No, 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 no. What a weird shadow. In terms of water, we are all the way up. We don't need to do that anymore. We are going to empty the stills, though, because the stills, as soon as they're full, they stop generating water. So unless you put it into a container, they just stop doing their job. So what we'll do is pop that in there. So we may as well have, I mean, we can carry the kindling and we can carry the palm fronds, and if we carry a couple of sticks, then we've got everything we need. We don't need that. Yeah, that's probably okay. Empty, empty, empty. And I think these had some stuff in them. Yeah, building materials and lashings. Good. Yes. So I mean, the cruel hammer. The crude hammer's useful. Coconut's useful. Vitamins. Ooh, the sun is going down. There we go. We got some light. That's okay. We do need our weapon pile as well. So we'll probably just work throughout the night. We'll drop. Can we fit that? Ooh, nope. Tab. Can we fit that in there? Yes, we can. Good. Well, at least that does something. And then we'll get our guns. Boop, boop. And we'll put them on here. Actually, Jesus, we got loads of guns. How many guns do we have? Flare gun. I thought we'd taken only two flare guns out, but it turns out we got one here, one here, one. Oh, we got loads of guns. It's a shame they're the only gun in the game. I would really like a Garand M1, and it'd just be like, smile, you son of a gun. And then it's just like, is it a moonless night? Oh, wow. Yeah, no, that sea is even more terrifying than it was before. No, there's the moon. It's sort of coming up. So we got a lantern down there. Cool. In terms of tools, do we need anything? No, I think the bow's been superseded with the gas gun and the... do we need the refined knife? We may as well take the knife. Probably don't need the coconut, to be honest. And now it's completely dark. Right, fine. Let's just drop that here. Boop. There we go. Cool. Absolutely brilliant. Oh yeah, we may as well light that to get these few bits of meat smoke. Kindling. There we go. Here we go. We got some kindling. So we'll get that smoking. You can go down there. Oh my god. All right. Fine. Eat a light. And we tap away, and it's almost completely pitch black. Without the light from the house and without the light from a wristwatch, we may as well just be playing a game about space. A space game. Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship. Enterprise. Okay, so we'll do that. We can't really see much. That's a problem. A problem for us. A problem. Wait, what? Oh, right. I was looking at the wrong trees. I was just like, oh, that tree's got a coconut. So is that one. But no. Panic. Don't panic, because it was these two trees, and that one's still got no coconut. Okay, fine. It may have been that we never picked the coconut off in the first place. I think when the morning comes, we will load up this raft in the light so we can actually see what we're doing. For the time being, we could just physics object this stuff over. So we still have a torch on. Let's do that. Let's just drag these back across the beach. Now, I think any more than about 7 and your raft starts going underwater. Bats? Hello? Oh, it's a bat. It's a bat. It's flying away. Flying away. Fly away, bat. Any more than about 7. I think we can just pick it up, couldn't we? Yep. Anything in there? So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, no, we can't do that. Okay, fine, whatever. Whatever, didn't want those things anyway. Oh, no, now we have to sort of pop them down on the beach. Okay, fine. It's dark. Real dark. Why is it so dark? And why is the moon over there? Is the moon not... What? Huh. That's strange. Stranger than fiction. If we look here... Oh, yeah, okay, so the moon's now in between these rocks. It's weird how perspective does that. It's nice though. I mean, it's the light of the moon and the god rays clipping through the pine. It's lovely. It's nice. But the time is 2028. So if we sleep now, we'll be about half an hour before sunrise. We can finish off. Doing stuff to the raft. So we'll save and then we'll sleep. So then we can load up the raft and get prepared for another day out. We've also left the stuff smoking overnight, which is kind of cool. So the fire will be out. So if we go look at this, the fire's out, but all the meat is smoked. Cool. So all the little fishies are all smoked. It's going to rain today. That's a pain in the butt. That's actually a pain in the butt. I don't want it to rain. We're loading up a raft anyway, so it's not going to be too much of a problem. Food is down by 2 things. So we go, nope. Now we get those 2, and then we can go... There we go. Oh, sunrise. It's 2 minutes. 2 minutes to the sunrise. It's kind of nice. There we go. And it's... Oh, it's already here. We'll just leap up on here and then watch. Holy crap. Holy crap. It always seems to be like a big marshmallow-shaped cloud in the sky when the sun comes up. Oh, the seagulls are nice, though. Huh. Yeah, I like that. I do like that. Okay, fine. So that's up. We got another day in paradise. Well, I say paradise. It's more sort of trying to not to get your face bitten off by a shark. So what we'll do is... I guess we have to pick all these up, don't we? Yep. All right, let's pick it up. Pick it up. Huh. Okay. So we'll leap up on here. And we shouldn't really leap up on here because, we drop this down. Yeah, every time we drop one of these on, it messes with the physics. That's a problem. I don't want to do that. I'm going to go open hand. Right. So we'll get a little bit closer. And then, I can feel this messing with the physics already. Oh, my God. That moved the raft. So that little bug's still in then. Yeah. There used to be that you could take a log, hold it on the back of your old rubber blow-up raft, and actually use it as an engine because of the way the physics works, and then make yourself explode across the sea, like super fast. So fast, in fact, that nothing could really catch you. So what we got? 1, 2, okay. So we get some... Well, I suppose it's raining now. That's a good thing. And all the stuff's on the beach and it's going to water the plants. So that's good. We'll drop that there. We're not going to walk in the middle area. And we're going to do that specifically so that... Because if we go in the middle area where there's no like walky bit, then we could end up... Physics, you heartless wench. Jesus. All right, can we get, can we grab the raft? No. The raft is now sort of drifting slightly out to sea and it's stuck on a rock. Let's do this. Okay, that's better. Wow. I mean, it's not that deep here, but it, because you can't see the bottom. Yeah, it looks terrifying. It looks absolutely terrifying. So we'll do this. And then we'll go to the other side. And I mean, we're on the raft. I mean, we could just, like, drive it back to the beach if we got stuck, you know. I don't trust the raft. Not, especially with the rain and stuff. This is spooky as anything. All right, can we... No, I don't like this. I really don't like this. All right, can we get you back up onto the beach? Yeah, that's better. That's better. It makes me feel happier, at least. Can we get you, like, actually locked in there? Nope, that's just on the beach. I'm being, like, a proper scaredy cat now. I mean, we were just swimming around, spearing fish in the face. But now that you can't see into the water, now the water is black. No, that is freaking me out. That is absolutely freaking me out. That's one of my problems. I really don't like the water when it goes completely opaque. It's just like, nah, because that could be like 2 feet. That could be infinite feet deep. And it could be hiding all manner of monsters as well. So we've got lashings. We've got palm fronds. We've got our axe. So we can axe ourselves a question. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is there anything in there? Nope. Anything in there? Nope. Do we need so many crates, to be honest? Anything in there? Yeah, scrap. I don't think we need that many crates, to be honest. Because we're going to find stuff out in the sea anyway. So if we drop 2 more down, then that should be okay. I think that would be okay. Oh, we're in the wrong bit. We're on the wrong bit. We don't want to physics ourselves into the sea. Oh boy. Yeah, this system is not a good system. There needs to be a way of creating a part of the raft that is actually, actually... Nice. Is actually part of, like, raft physics. Is actually... I'm going to get the sentence out eventually. Is a storage part of the raft, so you can actually build a raft that has proper storage integrated into it. Maybe even outriggers and stuff. That'd be cool. So you don't have to have these bits, but you can have like outriggers and stuff on your raft. And then you could be like, oh yes, my raft brings all the boys to the yard. And they're like, it's really quite good, no? So yeah, come on. There we go. So we just, one more. All right, this should be easy now that it stopped raining and we can stop freaking out. Like, literally, the water was black. It could have been infinite feet deep. There we go. We want them all to be sort of actually, like, laying on the bottom of the raft. Done. That was it. That's all we needed to do. I mean, we had the torch on this water and we couldn't see the bottom of the water. And it's literally that deep. It's not even that deep. I don't know. What do I know? Good. Well, that's sorted out. What else do we need? Well, we need to take some food with us. We certainly need to take some water with us. So we will grab the meats. And we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4. And what we could do is probably take another couple. Hold them with us, maybe? Nope. Let's do this. What is our water sitch like? So we're kind of way down in the water. Interestingly, the rain does not replenish the solar stills because they're a solar still and not a rain capture device. So it really should. It should just top these guys up all the way, but It doesn't. So, well, water's done. It's 10:11. It is good. We may as well put these buckets into one of the chests on the raft. And then we're pretty much good to go, I think. So if we do this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, get them all in. Yeah, it's getting one in. So we're holding some just in case it all explodes and we end up in the sea. And we do this. We got one or two. Good. Bucket of fresh water. We got our torch. Yes, so we got the kindling, we got the lashings, we got the torch, we've got the axe, we've got a knife, we've got ammunition for days. If we get the axe out, we go 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep, I think that's good. That's a good starting point. We can always make more ammunition in the future. We can always do other things in the future. We're not carrying too much to start with, and the rain has watered our farms. Good. I think what I'm going to do is give it a little save, a cheeky little save, because that means we can get all dungeon rings. So we'll hit save. And you know what? I think, oh, that's very clear. I think I'm going to call it there for the time being. So if you're liking this series, please like, subscribe, tell your friends about the channel, because that always helps. And I will join you next time for a voyage into, well, mostly known, but not quite completely unknown. So until then, bye!